Hello, let me tell you something about battery cum AC operated dual mode shunting loco, SARTHI, which has been developed by Electric Loco Shed Tughlakabad, West Central Railway. All the electric loco sheds have a lot of requirement of shunting the under repair and dead locomotives. Any healthy locomotive can do such in electrified areas. However, in the non-electrified areas where there is no OHE, shunting is accomplished by means of attaching extra dead locomotives or wagons. This is required because the non-electrified lines are to the tune of almost 90 meters in length. Thus, a single locomotive cannot shunt dead locomotives in the area. This process is unsafe, involves additional manpower, and is very much time consuming. Hence, as a long-lasting solution, one condemned WM4 locomotive was converted to a battery-cum-AC operated dual-mode shunting loco so that it can accomplish shunting in both OHE as well as non-OHE areas. The locomotive on screen is none other than a WM4 which has been converted into a dual-mode shunting locomotive. It works on battery as well as AC. The bogie one works on battery. Batteries which were used from three-phase locomotives and the bogie 2 works on OHE. The locomotive that is shown here has only 4 traction motors, 2 for each bogie. The weight has been optimized in order to ensure sufficient push or pull torque to pull or push 2 or more locomotives. The circuit has been modified suitably so that battery supply can be fed to the traction motors directly. The layout on screen depicts the arrangement of equipment in the existing locomotive, that is the WM4, and the modified locomotive, that is the shunting locomotive. Some equipments have been removed from the previous WM4 locomotive in order to create space so that new equipment can be accommodated to modify the previous loco to a battery operated locomotive. As only bogie 1 has been converted from OHE to battery, thus most of the equipments such as MVMT1, CP1, CP2, SJ1, SJ2, RSI1, MVSL1 have been removed, and the space has been utilized to put battery sets, chargers and other equipment which are required to ensure that one bogie can operate on battery. The shunting contactors have been used in order to create notching arrangement for the battery operated bogie. The battery voltage supplied is either 24 volts or 48 volts by means of 2 notches to the traction motors in bogie 1. The bogie 2 arrangement is kept same, however only 2 traction motors are used per bogie. A separate HBS switch has been used so that the driver can decide whether to work on battery or on OHE. It has been given 2 positions, one for working in battery, that is bogie 1, and one for working on OHE, that is bogie 2. The MPS switch in position 1 and 2 is used for notching purposes in battery operation. 2 extra CPAs have been accommodated in the pneumatic circuit in order to maintain the pressure for braking while working on battery mode. These are the additional batteries which have been removed from 3-phase locomotive and kept in this locomotive to supply to traction motors. The complete circuitry has been modified in-house and set of instructions have been issued to all shunters in order to ensure smooth operation of the shunting locomotive. It is worthwhile to say that all the shunters find it extremely easy and comforting to use this locomotive. As it is clearly evident in the video that our locomotive SARTHI is pulling 2 additional locomotives attached. None of the locomotives as seen in the video is having their pantos raised. It is clear that SARTHI is working on battery mode and it is very easily able to haul both the locomotives. In the current video it is seen that SARTHI is able to haul 2 locomotives on OHE. Thus, Both the operations, that is OHE based as well as battery based, are sufficient to haul locomotives in either push or pull operation. This enables placement of any locomotive in any kind of bay, whether it is wired or unwired. Once SARTHI is in OHE area, the OHE can be used to charge the batteries which are placed within the locomotive for battery based operation. Thus, the batteries are recharged while working in the OHE area. As you can see on the visual screen, the layout of an electric loco shed is displayed. It is clearly evident that more than 50% of the working line areas do not have OHE. Hence, this innovation is a very important accomplishment to enable manpower and time saving. This innovation has numerous advantages, as it enables saving of manpower, time, and also enables ease of process. The savings in revenue are to the tune of almost 1.19 lakhs per month. Such solutions are available in the market, but the starting cost is not less than 2.5 crores. The same solution can be extrapolated and it can be used for shunting of rakes, wagons, etc. in yards and depots as well. In a nutshell, it is a safe and reliable solution which is easy to use and also long lasting. Thank you.